Hello and welcome to this video. We will be reviewing PDFCo API call activity here. Now we already have seen other activities like PDF merger, splitting PDF or converting PDF to different formats or filling the PDF. So these all activity underneath are using the PDF.co API call. If we want to directly consume the API call, we can consume using this activity. Main parameters it expects are the URL of the API and the input request, and the output response will be received in this parameter output response. Now let us see different APIs here. So I am here on the PDFCo documentations. So if you want to go to this page, you can go from PDFCo website and the documentations and the REST API docs. So here it is listing out all the APIs from PDF.co, and the API which we are demonstrating in this video is PDF/info. Here it is. So this particular API, as the name suggests, is giving all the information about the PDF. For example, if we have some input PDF provided as the URL like this, then it will give the information about the number of page counts, the author of this PDF, title of the PDF, in which software this PDF is produced, when it is created. If PDF is containing different tags, then it will also provide the information of that in the keyword property, as well as the size and bit height properties. Whole bunch of information regarding this PDF can be retrieved using this API. Now let us try to consume this API in UiPath. So I am copying and pasting API endpoint here, and let me also add the PDF request from here. So it is giving the extra space. Let me copy this input request here, and it is expecting the input in the string format. So I have to provide the escaping characters. For example, instead of the double quotes, I have to provide the two double quotes, so that whenever the request reaches the PDF.co, it will be in the proper format. Now I think the input request is completed. Now let me create a variable for this output response. So I'm right clicking here and creating the variable, and let us name this as output response. Okay, now let me also add the connecting message box here, so that we can display the output in the message box. So I'm setting the text as a variable which we just defined, output response. Now let us see this in action. So I'm executing here. Okay, so execution has been completed, and we can see all the information are received in the message box. So this is how easy we can directly consume the PDF.API call, and we can utilize the output in any way. For example, we can parse the JSON response, and we can use any of the keys in whatever the way we want. Thank you.